Rabin. 81st start again tonight with him, along with number 12 senior captain Brad Dunwell. 81 straight starts for those two. Mayor Fernandez lays it off to Desart. And the Deeks cutting this field in half. Machulpchul lost it. Spartan's going to go put the long ball out, but Sam Rabin right there. 1 shot between these two teams, and it's been by the UNCG Spartans. As Fernandez looks for Desart for his support. Gadula on the far right got an assist in the Duke game as well. Trying to use that right channel with Chulp Chul. Lapa trying to connect back with Chul. Cut out by UNCG. Lays it off, and a miscommunication there. Wake Forest back with possession. Trying to hook up with sophomore Nelson Osino. And now they'll try Chol sprinting down the right channel. And now we'll go out of bounds for a goal kick. A little slow start of the night. Trying the long ball, trying to maybe use the speed, and Casas Mundet decides to use his head. And the Spartans still here in the attacking third, and it'll be a throw-in. Tonight's referees are Trey Krell, assistant referee Aaron Gallagher, and Kevin Uto. Dunwell drifting to the far right. Gadula with a nice little overlapping run, but Scholl decides to keep it in the middle. Desart gets pulled down, no call, and here come the Spartans. Off the back of a pow. Sam Rabin able to get it back, and he'll just try to clear it as the Spartans are testing this number one team in the nation. Last of their three-game homestand for the Wake Forest Demon Deacons before they head up north to the land of the Orange of Syracuse, which will give you a game for sure. They are on the cusp of putting history in the books last year, but they end up with a tie to Syracuse 0-0. And the pressure. pressure is back off UNCG's back line. Four seniors starting tonight again for the Spartans. That's Lapa. Lapa checks for Holcomb, but will play Chol. Desart wants it, but he'll play Fernandez, who tucks here in the middle. And here's Chol inside the 18. Deflected. This should be a corner kick. So the first corner kick of the night will go to the Wake Forest Demon Deacons. As Bruno Lapa will trot over there to the right side. Played just about 10 minutes. It's 0-0. UNCG with the only shot so far. Godola trying to shield the ball off. This will be out of bounds and a throw in for the Spartans. Record of 43-6-1 against non-conference opponents in the last 4 years. Again, the impressive numbers of Coach Muse, who took over for Coach Jay Vidovich, who now is the head coach of Pittsburgh. And there's Omer Fernandez trying to get loose, poked away. Desarts there to keep possession back to Wake Forest. Holcomb pointed to try to use the right channel, but Wake Forest will play it the smart way and just move it around the back. There's Dunwell right in the middle. Might not show up on the stat sheet, but he's imperative that he plays well for this Demon Deacons. Take him! Get a win. Got a nice goal here by Bruno Lapa. Oh, there was a deflection. But you saw Milligan kind of move to his left. Let's take a look. This is Bruno Lapa's. Oh, it's off of Holcomb. So Holcomb's third goal of the year for the freshman, deflected from a shot by Bruno Lapa. Three goals and one assist for the freshman, a part of this number two recruiting class, and all the land for Bobby Muse. And the score 1-0 for Wake Forest. Tough for Milligan, though. Was in the right spot, but deflected well by the freshman Holcomb, and he puts it in the back of the net. Just when you thought Bruno Lapa had goal number 10 on the year, it's freshman Kyle Holcomb.
Wake Forest goal scored by Fernandez, number three, Kyle Holcomb.
Pushed that one to our front of him.
Bruno Lapa.
UNCG trying to get one right back here. Down 1-0. Zeddy folds slowly moving down this left line, which we'll see a lot in this first half. Lapa looked like he was going to continue his streak. But the freshman, Kyle Holcomb, got a boot on it. And he got his third goal of his freshman campaign. Planel. Casas Mundet all the way off his line and past the 18. But again, he's very comfortable with his feet. Lapa displaying some skill, gets taken down. It'll be a free kick. That was Magarushu. Leroy Magarushu, the senior from France. See him right behind, and they're going to call that all the time there, right there in the middle. Active leader in points scored in the Southern Conference, Magarushu. six-game winners in his career in Greensboro. Fernandez, just a little heavy on that touch. Seen that about twice so far tonight, unlike Omer Fernandez. Holcomb comes up, meets it. Wake up 1-0, their first shot. Deflected by Kyle Holcomb. After a nice look by Bruno Lapa. And it got past John Milligan for the goal. John Milligan has been superior for coach Justin Mullen. In his senior year, gonna try to go long, but this is gonna just roll right to Folds, and Folds will play Raven on the right side. Three goals now for Wake Forest on the year. Number one in scoring offense, number one in total points, number one in the nation in total assists. But 1-1 on the shots on goal category for both teams. Wake Forest with that one save, which Casas Mundet had a shot directed right at his chest. Check out this foul here. Samir Fernandez trying to cut it in the middle and pulled down by Apo. Manny Apo, the sophomore. Lapa trying to connect with his roommate, Omer Fernandez. Right in the seam, here come the Spartans. Trying to lay it off, and yeah, that's gonna be a penalty called on to Shields. Maybe tripped up. Almubaslat. And the Shields protesting that, but Almubaslat sold it well, the junior. Summerfield, North Carolina. Played at Northern Guilford, not too far from here. That's one goal on the year with 15 shots. So again, here's a set piece, which Wake Forest is trying to work on. They've had their issues, and let's see what they do here. Not a good idea by the Spartans, but still inside the 18. They want the call, they say play on. Magarushu hit the ground. The captain pleading with the referee for a penalty kick. Let's take a look. It's to Shields. And trying to poke it away. Wake Forest tripped up Duke in the box on Saturday. And a PK. Made it their second goal. Wake Forest came back and put insurance back on with a goal by Machop Chol. Speaking of Duke, they are down 1-0 to Wofford right now. We're keeping an eye on the scores. The 15th minute. Chol trying to get inside the 18. The stride by Machul Chol. And some space over here to the left for Omer Fernandez. See if Fernandez tries. Now he's going to play Lapa. And they switch fields to the right side, and there's Gadula. Desart wants it. But they'll play the support role. with Dunwell. Lop up, one touch to Chol. Chol right to Kyle Holcomb. And Kyle Holcomb had a small window and he knew it. Gonna have to take a one touch on frame and it was deflected and out of bounds for a corner kick for Wake Forest. Let's take a look.
Sound the alarm for a Wake Forest
well defended back there
South.
By Josh Maston. Two of the seniors in the back line there for UNCG. Here comes the corner kick by Lapa. Could not get over the head. The UNCG defense. Second corner of the night for Wake Forest. UNCG has yet to try one. Well defended. Gadula put a nice try on that, but it'll go out of bounds for another corner for Wake Forest.
Sound the alarm for a Wake Forest corner kick presented by Alarm
Duke
South.
Duke has now tied it up against Wofford, so it's 1-1. Between those two squads, Duke, who clocked in at 15th in the nation Saturday night. Here's the corner high, and they dropped to 23rd after a loss to Wake Forest, which is the number one team in the NCAA. Still ACC dominant in the top 25 category. We'll get to that later on. Dunwell drifts away from his normal position right in the middle. Omer Fernandez puts it in fifth gear. Now he's going to cut in the middle, try to connect with Holcomb, but cut out by the Spartans. That was a good eye way to read it. By Alex Henderson, the sophomore. Chol, the long stride on the right. And this should be another corner. It is. Four corners now for Wake Forest on the evening. Played just over 20 minutes here in the first half. Wake Forest up 1-0. Here they are in the attacking third again. Forest likes to cut the field in half, and they do such a superb job as you see Sam Rabin moving from on the far right back line all the way to the near side here as he'll trot right back to his same position. But the Deacons like to spice things up, move all their personnel around. That's probably a good reason why they lead the nation and goals. They did last year, and they're back on top again, despite losing five of their top six goal scorers from 2017. Fernandez trying to slot one to Holcomb, and that'll be a free kick. As Holcomb, I believe, got stepped on. So a free kick for Wake Forest. Right outside of the 18, Casas Mundet from Barcelona, Spain. Again, played with that Barcelona B team. Came over to the States to play for Coach Bobby Muse. And one of the program's best keepers in program history. They'll call for 10 yards, and they'll back him up. So it's Lapa and Fernandez is the options for the free kick here. Dunwell. He was trying to go to Fernandez. Couldn't quite get it high enough. Chol with a one touch to Zark. Lapa with a little scoop and trying to find Zark. And that looked good because Desart was right inside, close to the 6-yard mark. And Folds took that for granted. Zeppo was able to escape that scoop right there, trying to find Foles. I mean, excuse me, that was Desart.
Coming in for UNCG, number 11.
She had quite a few times on Bruno Lapa, being able to create all these opportunities in the attacking third. Just a touch on his vision. Right there, just scooping it, putting it in the air, and trying to find number 14, Joey Desart, into the hands of Casas Mundet. Mundet going to immediately play Bruno Lapa with a long throw. Fernandez coming into the middle, trying to make a run. Beautiful skill by the sophomore, and trying to connect with his sweet mate, Chole, and Chole just mistimed it. 21 minutes left to go in the first half. Wake Forest up 1-0 from a deflection by Kyle Holcomb, which I think surprised the crowd here at Spry Stadium. And UNCG still with a lot of confidence. Look at the speed there. I don't think the Shields, again, that's twice we've seen Wake Forest caught napping. There's a good play right there by Almubaslat. And I think they're taking the speed of this UNCG team for granted, because so many times it looks like they've got plenty of time to make some decisions, and UNCG has put it into fifth gear and come up with it. Almubaslat just had his head down, and you see just that angle closes immediately. So that particular situation, no, I don't know if anybody was making that run to the near stick or maybe into the middle. But as soon as that angle closed, it was tough for Almubaslat to put one in the back of the net and tie this thing up. You could clearly see why this UNCG team was picked to win this Southern Conference. Despite their record at 4-5, a very skilled side for Coach Justin Mullen. And plenty of pace, too. They'll start conference play right after this match between the Demon Deacons. They will host new member Belmont, 7 p.m. October 6th, as Folds gets tripped up. And UNCG not shy at all. That was Appel. And he looks like he's a little shaken off of that one. Walking a little gingerly. Quickly, free kick awarded to Wake Forest. They play it immediately to Lapa. Lapa has a miscommunication with his Omer Fernandez. Other games in play tonight. Virginia Tech taking on South Carolina. We'll get an update as soon as we can. Zadiks with three shots so far and a 1-0 lead. An offside call on Kyle Holcomb as he couldn't quite time that run. There is the leaders in the NCAA. Wake Forest with 10 games and 33 goals now. Counting tonight. 33 goals. Wright State right there behind them. Wake Forest last year had 58 goals total 2017 season, and they're right on pace to get that or maybe even beat that mark.
Now playing for the Spartans, number 26, Micah Albert. Coming in for the Wake Forest team,
27 consecutive weeks in the top
15,
five.
Isaiah Parente,
who got the first goal of his freshman campaign against the Duke Blue Devils. A beautiful header. He checks into the ballgame for Wake Forest. Virginia Tech ahead of South Carolina. We told you to give you an update on that. They're up 1-0 to South Carolina. Wake Forest will play South Carolina down in Columbia a little later this season. So Deacon's going to try to knock it around here. Triangle passing, but possession back to the Spartans. As Cadula went hard on that tackle. Casas Mundet doesn't want any time to delay. Interesting to see Amir Fernandez cutting into the middle a little bit more. Usually they pull him out, stretch the field on the width-wise, but Fernandez has kind of drifted there into the middle tonight. And the pressure back off the UNCG back line. Matt Mattis checked in for UNCG, along with Micah Albert. And the other substitution for Wake Forest was Alistair Johnston, the transfer from St. John's, who got an assist on Saturday night. Long ball, great run by Almubaslat. Three shots for Wake Forest, two for UNCG. Tied on the shots on frame with one apiece. Six fouls between these two clubs. Now one offside call on Kyle Holcomb, and just couldn't quite time his run. Throw in for UNCG, and this little stat by Jay Garneau, we'll call this the more you know by Garneau in basketball. The best offense are known for making the extra pass, passing up a good shot to a teammate for a great shot, but the same can be said for Wake Forest men's soccer team. Out of the Deacs, 28 goals in the run of play, 26 have been assisted, including 11, which had double assists. That unselfish passing has been a nightmare for opposing keepers, and Wake Forest opponents have a minuscule .568 save percentage this year. So let's take that for comparison. None of the 206 Division I teams in the country have a season save percentage that low. Those totals have helped Wake Forest lead the nation in both goals with 33 and assists at 37. Five more than any other team. The More You Know by Jay Garneau, our SID. As UNCG trying to level this thing up. And the service, great idea. They had some options inside the 18. just under 12 minutes to go in the first half. Wake Forest holding on to a 1-0 lead. Closing out their three-game homestand. Played Davidson last Tuesday night, then Duke on Saturday night. And tonight against Southern Conference UNCG Spartans. Hernandez in the middle. Can Lapa get there? He does. Wake Forest trying to create something here. Parente able to turn. Fernandez wants it, and Lapa wanted to go to him, but he'll play his support with Parente. And that'll be a free kick. Is late on that and a reckless challenge. It might be a car, but let's take a look. It's Fernandez. Always quick to get there. A little late there by Alex Henderson, the sophomore. Kind of got the heels of Fernandez. Let's see if Wake Forest can add to their lead here, right outside of the 18. Chol Parente behind it. Usually we see Lapa, but this time we'll see freshman Parente behind it. And he takes a shot with some pace around it. It just couldn't get through the wall. Parente again with it. Kick save by the Spartan defense. I see Lapa moving all the way over here to this near side. It's interesting to see how this offense is moving around. So many moving parts. Chol playing, starting the game on that far right with Omir Fernandez on the far left. But Fernandez has tucked in.
Now
you see Lapa moving over to the outside.
And number 18, Landon Haig.
And Landon Haig, redshirt freshman, makes his second appearance, I believe, on the season. And Holland Rula, the freshman who got the game winner against Davidson, checks into the ball game for Coach Bobby Muse. Haig did not come to it, and the ball is taken back by the UNCG Spartans. Spartans on the attack here, trying to level this thing up. Look at the speed. Here's a service right behind Almubaslat. Unlucky, though, because Almubaslat was making a nice run right there in the middle, right in front of Casas Mundet. Haig trying to make the run. Just to come back as the back line moves up. Parente. Parente going to try. Well played by the Spartan defense. Alistair Johnston challenging. Pressure back off Wake Forest's back line as they creep up. You see Folds again moving up. Wanted to play Rula. This time he'll play Rula. UNC Tar Heels up 1-0 to UNCW. Both teams ranked. Here's the service. Parente was just about a hair too late there, but had the right idea as Parente was making a nice run into the box. Just couldn't quite throw his boot
there
to put one in.
Spartans, number six, Nicholas
Magite. More Spartans come
number
in. There's
10,
three
Moises
Spartans
Gonzalez,
that check back in.
And number 19, Tevin Henry.
Tevin Henry,
for the Demon Deacons, number nine,
his first
Tanner
time
Renhack
on the pitch for the Spartans. Tater Renhack. For Wake Forest. Micah Albert, Rula fighting for it. It'll be a throw in for the UNCG Spartans. Five and a half to go. Here in this first period. UNCG is holding Wake Forest, despite allowing that goal, is holding Wake Forest to five shots, which is pretty impressive considering they're averaging about 15 shots per game. Long ball trying to test the Shields. Parente wants it, and they'll play him. Deeks went into the locker room against Davidson last Tuesday night, tied 1-1. As Rula displaying some skill there, and then came back with some extra pop, and out came by the freshman. Rula, Colby Carr. Tackled by DeShields, and they're going to call a foul on DeShields. Like he timed that right, but the referee says not on his watch. As DeShields just waits and then goes immediately at it. They call the foul on the sophomore from Baltimore, Maryland. Casas Mundet got tripped up. He came off his line, and Casas Mundet is kind of signaling at the ref. Trying to see what exactly happened. Good job by our crew again with this immediate replay. It looked like he got tripped up by Tater Renhack. Good news for Casas Mundet and the Deacons. They keep the Spartans from putting one in the back of the net. Rula tiptoeing the line, now cut in the middle. Micah Howard challenged him, but Rula still with possession. Rula usually plays in the back, has now been used quite a few times on that outside left attacker. He looks pretty comfortable, too. To put a nice left foot service inside the box, curling just right, but could not connect with Lapa or Haig. Just about 2 minutes left to go. See if Wake Forest can try to put goal number two, or can UNCG level this thing up? Had to go to overtime against Campbell. Campbell had 10 men, but had a PK to tie it up. And UNCG used the expertise of the freshman to get the win in the fourth win for the Spartans on the 2018 campaign. So Magarushu come out, and it's Julian Montoya who comes in for Coach Justin Mullen. Seven substitutions so far for the Spartans. Using as many fresh legs as they can against this number one team.
1 minute. This Mast Minute is brought to you by Mast General
Store. 1 minute now remains.
Be on the lookout for Mast merchandise and take a minute to visit us on Trade Street in downtown Winston-Salem.
Lake Forest. So with a 1-0 lead, looks like the Spartans are going to take their time and try to create something here to tie it up. For the long throw, and that is a long throw for sure. Parente just trying to clear it, still in the attacking third, the Spartans chipping away. 20 seconds left in the first half. Try to go the long ball, and Tater Rinhack with the interception.
Lake
Forest are just going to take their time and let the time go out here in the first half, holding on to a 1-0 lead after a deflection from a Bruno Lapa shot that deflected off of Kyle Holcomb. And as a result, he got his third goal of his freshman campaign. 1-0 our score. As we head to the locker room, Wake Forest, after trying to connect with Bruno Lapa, making his 10th goal of his year, but the freshman had other ideas. As Wake Forest leads, UNCG 1-0. We'll be back with more coming up here at Spry Stadium.
Deacon fans, tonight's first half was presented by Fratelli's Italian Steakhouse.
That is shaping up to be a huge game at Louisville at number 6. You see Seattle rounding out the number 25. Stanford had dropped out of the top 25. Duke at 23, who was 15 coming in on Saturday. And there's the standings again, going back to what type of matchup we're looking at when Louisville comes in here. And the end of the month, Louisville at 3-0-1, and they're only... Well, that loss was to Kentucky, who is now fourth in the nation. And again, will take on Indiana on Wednesday. That'll be a matchup to look for. And there's the highlights from the first half so far. We saw a lot of Amir Fernandez coming into the middle, and then DeShields getting picked on a lot by the offense of the Spartans. Really, by Magarushu, who is only player for UNCG with two shots, one on frame, and Wake Forest, who has the lead 1-0, have tried to create some opportunities, have only put five shots on the books. So you see the beautiful play by Bruno the Great. A nice little scoop trying to find Desart. And there's the deflection, and you just got to feel for goalkeeper John Milligan, because he had the right direction for where Bruno Lapa was going to put it, but a deflected ball by Kyle Holcomb switches the spot, and it goes to the left and in for Wake Forest and makes it 1-0. Shots on goal. There's Wake Forest with five, averaging about 15 shots per game. They're sitting at five here in the first half. Saves only one, and that was by Casas Mundet. In the foul department, a little physical, you'd say. Five on UNCG, three on Wake Forest. And Milligan still sits with no saves, but allowing one goal off that deflection. This will be the third goal he's allowed since he started back in the net for the Spartans, 4-5-0. There's their schedule. It'll be on the SoCon Digital Network against Wofford and then ESPN Plus, where they'll welcome in Belmont, 7 p.m. They played Belmont back in 2006, I believe. That was the last time they beat them 5-2. Belmont is now the new member of the Southern Conference. Coming in, they'll play also ETSU on October 13th. If you remember, East Tennessee State came here, put two goals on the scoreboard against Wake Forest. Wake Forest did win 4-2, and they travel to Virginia Military Institute. But UNCG prepping themselves with a stout schedule for 2018. And now they're ready for the Southern Conference matchup, because they were picked to win the Southern Conference. And they're primed and ready as they trail to number one Wake Forest 1-0. Wake Forest ending their three-game homestand as they'll head to the upper part of New York against Syracuse. They'll come back here on Tuesday, a week from now, against High Point, Boston College, which will be broadcasted by Fox. Then they head down to Columbia, and then you can circle that on October 20th, because the rivalry between the Cavaliers and Wake Forest is hard to ignore. Virginia, who is presently number 10 in the nation, they've got Duke coming in October 5th. Clemson are at Clemson, which Clemson may not be ranked, but anybody who's familiar with ACC soccer know that Clemson Tigers are nothing to mess with. They'll be taking on UVA on October 20th. That's Wake Forest and UVA. And the wins since 2015, look how impressive that is. 65 wins since Coach Bobby Muse came back to Winston-Salem. You remember he was an assistant back in the years where they won the national championship in 2007. He went to Denver, which right there at third with 54 wins. And now he comes back to Wake Forest and has just been, you can't even put a description on what kind of impact he has been on this program. 65 wins for Coach Bobby Muse and 46 wins total here at Spry, a record of 46-6-3. Now the good news, if you're a Spartan fan, is with all those wins and those very few losses, he's had two losses on a Tuesday. So there you go for a little thing of hope for UNCG. Wake Forest, 22 of their 32 goals have been popped in. Good example, that was on Saturday. They again turned on the heat. They also did it on Tuesday, last Tuesday against Davidson. Let's see what we have in store here for the next 45 for Wake Forest. They're behind their pace at 15 shots per game with five here in the first half as we start the second half. And DeShields again starts the second half on the left. You see a little brace on his knee. He had his work cut out for him against Duke, but a solid defender back there in the back line for the Wake Forest Demon Deacons. see if they can try to create something, or will we get a look at the freshman Plannell? We got the game winner against Campbell. Also checking in with some other scores around the ACC, around the region, with Carolina up 1-0. It's UNCW, which UNCW is also ranked 12th in the nation. The Seahawks have really had a good year. They had a pretty good year last year, and they continue this year. Down 1-0 to the Tar Heels, who are presently third in the nation. Virginia Tech holding onto a 1-0 lead against South Carolina. And now Virginia and Wright State right there behind Wake Forest, and goals scored, tied with Virginia 1-1. Came back to tomorrow's game against Kentucky, Indiana and Kentucky. Sounds like a basketball matchup, but it's a huge matchup in the game of college soccer. Number 2, Indiana Hoosiers taking on number 4, Kentucky. Interesting to see how the Hoosiers head to the bluegrass state. See if they can get a nice win over number 4, Kentucky. As the Deacs hold back on the pressure, Alistair Johnston starts again in the second half for Wake Forest, as well as Landon Haig, redshirt freshman. Just has a knack for scoring goals. Indiana has one of the toughest schedules in the nation. You saw them in game number 1 against this Wake Forest team. The Spartans trying to tie this up again, as they've done really well and they've had a couple opportunities. But besides Magashu, they have not had any other players with a good look at the frame. Duel all the way down here. Wanted to go to Parente. We'll play Alistair Johnston. Johnston puts it just a little too far out in front, but still tiptoeing that goal line. And the whistle blown, and they're going to call a free kick for the Spartans. It's Alistair Johnston. A little heavy on the touch there, but crept into the 18. UNCG trying to get 10 wins again. One of 27 D1 teams to win at least 10 games in each of their last 3 years. They sit right now at 4 wins on the season. So they get ready to embark on their conference schedule right after this match. Last year, remember, they lost to Mercer in the Southern Conference Championship. Trying to get back to the dance. They've been to the tournament 18 times, but they have not been back since 2010. Come on now. you want to lose it if you're the Wake Forest Demon Deacons. And I tell you what, they had Almubaslat right here to the left, all wide open. Almubaslat was with no black jerseys around him, and Sam Rabin, the captain, was able to stick his boot out and stop that pass. Parente, who came into the game in the first half, he's back out here in the second half. Lapa or Omer Fernandez did not start the second half, as Coach Muse will work with his depth. One touch. Beautiful soccer there, Alistair Johnston. Wanted to go back to Rula. Now plays him. Gadula backpedals here close to this near side. Parente knocked off the ball. No call. UNCG with the possession. And here come the Spartans. Almubaslat tried to keep it in play. Deflected off of Wake Forest and a throw in for the Spartans. Casey Pinlan with the throw. And here's the freshman. Jacob Plannell. Didn't look like a freshman right there with the kind of poise he had and the confidence he had on the ball. Captain versus captain there. As Magarushu knocked into Dunwell. Desert. Haig trying to come up for it. Plays Rula on the flank. A little bit of communication there between Haig and Rula. Duke has gone ahead of Wolford 2-1 in the 50th minute. Three freshmen on the pitch for the Deacons, and there's one of them, Parente. Johnston couldn't turn. Trying to play back to Parente and cut out by UNCG. This will be a throw-in for the Spartans. Spartans, pretty tough schedule themselves. Face 11 opponents, finished in the top 130 in the RPI category last year. Of course, Wake Forest, one of them, they finished number one. They were supposed to play North Carolina. That got canceled due to Hurricane Florence. It affected North Carolina State as well as state of South Carolina. We wish all those affected by it the best. From right here in Winston-Salem. Just played about 10 minutes here in the second half, and Wake Forest still have not put a shot yet. So they went into the locker room with five shots and one goal. And UNCG has kept the Deacons' attack at bay. UNCG with two shots. So now they work it here into the attacking third. Try to test Costas Mundet, probably about a 30-yard shot by Pinlan as he crept up from the back. Try to see if he can catch Costas Mundet napping. Gadula getting wrestled down, and UNCG back with the ball. This is a pool, and here's a shot, and And that had some pace behind it. Just hit the sign of the Walt Chisholm Alumni Hillside. Teed it up, and that is Magarusha, who again puts another shot under his name tonight. Senior from Milton Keynes, England. Here's the freshman. Plannell trying to lay it off, and Rule going to cut that out. And Haig cannot place it back to Rula. Leroy Magarushu, the former Southern Conference Freshman of the Year. The only player with the shots for UNCG. Besides Pinlan after that long one he tried from 30 yards out. This time it looks like Wake Forest is going to make some substitutions. Machulk Chol looks like he'll come back into the game. Haig will go out. Looks like Kobe Carr is warming up on the Wake Forest bench. Made his debut against the Davidson Wildcats. Of course, got a goal to go with it. Big crowd here Saturday night. Not too bad here on a Tuesday night. It's a triad rival in UNCG. Trying to go long and test the back line with the speed of what UNCG has up front. Almubaslat. Beautiful skill. Almubaslat puts one with his left foot. A nice look as it just goes over the crossbar. That foot had some spin. Goes right over. But a good attempt by Almubaslat, the junior from Summerfield, North Carolina. His father played for the U-20 Jordan national team. So it comes from soccer blood. Had 3 goals and 2 assists last year. 2 of those were game winners. Desart. Raven. Parente, an overlapping run by Kobe Carr, who has checked into the game for Coach Bobby Muse. The freshman from San Antonio, Texas. Another key part of this number 2 recruiting class that Coach Muse brought in. To Shields. Misplayed that one. This is a good look for the Spartans. They chip it, trying to chip over Casas Mundet. Plannell was right there, which Plannell is not at all small. A freshman from Sweden, from Tabby, Sweden, was right there, as well as Almubaslat making that far stick run. And back on the pitch, number 16, Omer Fernandez. Had a little rest coming out of the locker room. Just under 30 minutes to go here in the second half, and Wake Forest holding on to a 1-0 lead. Still have yet to register a shot here in the second half. As UNCG has actually tested Casas Mundet three times here in the second half. So tied on the shots category at five apiece. Omer Fernandez trying to get loose a little too far up front. Of course, his speed, he's able to get it right back. Oh, ho! Saw that beautiful display there, wrapping his foot around it. Not shy at all. The only offside call by Parente as he just mistimed his run as Fernandez makes a run on the left side. And more black jerseys about to check in. Looks like Alistair Johnston will check back out. Kyle Holcomb and Bruno Lapa, both who started the night for Wake Forest, they come back in here in the second half. Deacons moving in and out, a lot of fresh legs to prepare for their long trip to New York. Carr lays it over to Chole, and Chole will play his support to Desart. Lapa looks for his 10th goal of his junior season. Thought he had it, but it was deflected off of Kyle Holcomb and went into the back of the net, and that's all the scoring we've seen tonight. Planell keeps it himself, and now he's going to try the left side. But Almubaslat making a move, and Colby Carr showing just how good a defender he is. Between two white jerseys, Lapa. Yes, the Spartans have done a pretty good job of trying to shut down number 10. Lapa, does he get a chance here? Lays it off to his sweet mate, Fernandez, with a goal. Just talked about being unselfish and how this Wake Forest team is. There's the sweet mates right there dancing. Fernandez had it right on the platter, and he put it in. And Omer Fernandez now with eight goals here on his sophomore year out of the Bronx, New York. The Manchester United fan with eight goals and three assists. He was all ACC freshman last year with six goals and five assists, and clutch goals at that. As three game winners coming in to tonight. They scored at least three goals in every game this season, Wake Forest has. You wouldn't think that because of how many players left for the MLS last year. Of course, you had the Mack Herman Trophy Award winner, Baquero, who left. We graduated and got drafted by the Chicago Fire. There will be a corner kick for Wake Forest. And it's just Bobby Ball that this team has bought into, and it works because now it's 34 goals on the year for Wake Forest as they lead UNCG 2-0. A little keep away here with the ball boy and Bruno Lapa. An outswinger by Lapa. As De Shields gets there into the middle. And Fernandez going 1v1 against John Milligan. You talk about UNCG goalkeepers. You can't not talk about Jay Benfield, who, by the way, is a Winston-Salem native, who's second in UNCG history with saves, with 239 in his career as a Spartan. Now the head coach at Mount Tabor High School, about 3 minutes from here. Played at West Forsyth, so that's a bit of a rivalry, and now he's coaching Mount Tabor. Had a save percentage, about 80% of the shots he faced, he saved. UNCG trying to get a goal here, down 2-0. Lapa with the assist to Omir Fernandez. That puts his total up to 7 assists on the year. 9 goals and 7 assists for the junior out of Brazil at Montverde Academy. There he is playing his other sweet mate, Matrope Chol. And they call a foul on Lapa, and I believe Lapa is right to question that because he kind of ran smack in the back of him. Let's take a look again. Well done by our crew as usual. Just kind of ran into the back. Tough call to make. Hit Casey Pinland. I think Alex Henderson. Dezart. Kind of have your head on a swivel there as they came in hard. Penalty awarded to Wake Forest. Deke still putting on a little pressure, even with a 2-0 lead. Their first shot of the second half was Omir Fernandez putting in the back of the net. See Coach Muse still never happy. He's up 2-0 and he's still wanting to throw in for Wake Forest. An option over here on the left with Pinland making a nice run. Colby Carr. Chol puts it on the turf. Now if you expected Desart to make a run, but Desart stayed back in possession back to the Spartans. Baslot calling for it. They're going to play him. But just won't get over the head of Rabin. But Rabin kind of not put the exact touch he wanted on because it did not move in the direction with the pace that he wanted. But Wake Forest still with possession. And here comes number 10, Lapa. Lapa chips it over trying to connect with Kyle Holcomb. Talked with Lapa last week to talk about the chemistry he has with Omir Fernandez. And obviously, they're sweet mates, but they put in some extra time during the offseason to get that chemistry up. It didn't just happen overnight. So they constantly would come out, practice field. Fields or in the Fields and here at Wake Forest and worked together. And that has really paid off. Has 16 goals between those two. Here's a shot. Scuffed it. Off the back of Desart. Pinland now with it. Still, the athletic ability and speed that UNCG possesses will definitely be a force in the Southern Conference. Trying to find Holcomb. Had the right idea. Well played by Omir Fernandez. You just see a streak of red with those red boots that he's got on. Under 20 minutes to go. Wake Forest with a 2-0 lead over UNCG. Trying to move to 11-0 on the season. As the Spartans back off the pressure on the back line. Well, Rabin is the vocal leader back here. This back line, especially also for this team. Dunwell, the other captain. They like to call him the quiet leader. Just sees the field in a manner that not a lot of players do. The reason why he has 81 straight starts. South Carolina has leveled it with Virginia Tech 1-1 here in the 43rd minute. And Duke has surged ahead of Wofford 3-1. UVA and Wright State still tied at one apiece. Thanks to my intern, Haley Brook, HB, with the dab. Spartans trying the right channel. Still trying to find some way, somehow, of getting one in the back of the net against Wake Forest. UNCG with only 12 goals on the season. Pinland. Just couldn't wrap his body around that as that drifts over the crossbar out of bounds for a goal kick for Wake Forest. And you see a bunch of white jerseys about to check in for Coach Justin Mullen. Lamate back in. Matt Mattis, who checked in the first half, is back on the pitch. Justin Mullen, the coach over at UNCG on his ninth year. As you see the substitutions, Trayvon Henry. Come on, guys, get it out of there. Drafted by the Eastern Indoor Soccer League and then came back to his alma mater as an assistant, William Carey College. The success that he had there for the NAIA was pretty remarkable. Back-to-back national semifinal appearances, number one ranking in 1997 and 1998. And then he took over in Greensboro. There's a free kick. It looks like the referee is going to call time and maybe give Kobe Carr a yellow. He does. Interesting call there. Let's maybe see that again. Great job by our crew. Which, a little tough to make that call because it looks like he hit ball first and then tripped him up. Which I believe that's what Colby Carr was protesting. A Kobe Carr gets a yellow card and a free kick awarded to the Spartans. I believe Magarushu is going to take it, chips it, floater inside the box. You see Casas Mundet yelling. Not sure if he saw some reckless play inside the box, but he is not happy. Very animated over there. And for a nice quiet Tuesday night, here's a scoring summary. 11th minute was Kyle Holcomb from a deflection from a Bruno Lapa shot. And then the 64th minute was Omir Fernandez with a beautiful pass by Bruno Lapa. Here's Kyle Holcomb. Fernandez, he's going to give it a shot. What a rip. Such a quick release, if you could say that in soccer. A quick trigger as he looks like he's just trying to move the ball up, and it quickly gets off his foot with tremendous pace. And off the gloves of John Milligan, as it was just tough to corral. And a corner kick for Wake Forest. The header off the knee of Fernandez and up and over the crossbar. 7 corner kicks for Wake Forest, only 1 for UNCG. Let's take a look at this sequence, just how things came about. Beautiful header by Holcomb. And maybe Fernandez got away with a handball, but it popped it right back to the freshman Holcomb, and Holcomb just could not get down on it. It goes over the crossbar. So 13 and a half to go. Wake Forest up 2-0. And in the shot category, believe it or not, the Spartans have the lead 8-7. Two saves for Casas Mundet, only 1 for Milligan. And again, 7 corner kicks to UNCG's 1. Fouls kind of calmed down despite that yellow card given to Kobe Carr. But 15 total on the night so far. Wake Forest clocked in here this evening with 57 corners to their opponent's 27. Now they have 64 on the year. And here's a little shocker in the great state of South Carolina. 1-1, Clemson in College of Charleston tied up. And the Cavaliers go ahead of Wright State 2-1. Here's a card. It's going to be given to Micah Albert. Let's see exactly as Lapa. Reckless tackle right there. Lapa very late with that tackle. Lapa goes down, and hopefully Lapa's okay. He looks to be okay. Second yellow card given tonight, this time to UNCG, Micah Albert. Another foul this time that was a push by a UNCG player on Dunwell, the captain. 1-1 tie in the great state of South Carolina with Charleston and Clemson. Clemson trying to smooth things out. They're trying to get their chemistry. They lost some players from last year's team. Diego Campos, one of them. It's time now a factor for UNCG if they're going to try to get a result here. down 2-0. They use the outside flank and then cut out, but out of bounds. A throw in for UNCG. Let's see if we see a long throw in here, which is a dangerous weapon to have, that they'll play it short. Magarushu. Poked away, but still, here's a shot and off to the right. I believe that was Magarushu again. He had a small window of an opportunity. And he put it on his left, just half to the right. Looks maybe he's cramping. It has been pretty hot here, especially for October here in the Triad. As the referee will call for an assistance by the trainers. Wake Forest with that. 10.5 to go, moving the record to 11-0. And Coach Muse looking for win number 66. Again, let's take a look. ESPN Plus will have that game, Belmont at 7 p.m., the new member of the Southern Conference. Then they go to Watford, which, by the way, is now down to Duke 3-1. And then East Tennessee State, which I'm sure they have that circled. East Tennessee State, which was a very nice side. They played well here against Wake Forest. They'll take them on the 13th of October. And there's Wake Forest's slate. With two away games back-to-back, one in Columbia, and then they move up to the state of Virginia against UVA. Boston College will be here on October 12th. It'll be 8 o'clock kickoff time. And, of course, a week from tonight will be High Point, which High Point is a dangerous side as well. High Point has not really gotten the recognition yet nationally, but the Deacs are very familiar with the High Point Panthers. And so is this UNCG team, who lost to them earlier this season. It looks like Magarushu is off the pitch for the Spartans. Not sure exactly what happened. He had a small window and took a shot on frame, which he's had a lot of chances tonight. As Holcomb going to fight for it, still up 2-0. Holcomb wants a brace on the night. Fernandez had the right idea. Immediately what you want to do on that side is place a ball in the center for a player making a run. Really wasn't any kind of option there, but Omer Fernandez has got to be a pest for the back lines of any opponent. Good reason why Coach Bobby Muse immediately lit up when you bring Omer Fernandez up, especially last year, his freshman year. Walked on to practice, came on and said, "You got to check this kid out, Omer Fernandez." Colby Carr moving into the middle, into the attacking third. Defenders for Wake Forest are not at all scared to creep up to the attacking third. Kadniachi on the left side, a player from Sweden that was brought in his freshman class, played in that second to the highest level in professional soccer for Sweden. Very technical player. Coach Muse looks to try to look towards the future, as Raven will be graduating after this year. Folds will be a senior next year. Always an eye on the future. Fernandez into the middle. Fernandez still at his feet. Deflected. had a chance of maybe spinning into the back of the net. Ten shots apiece between the two clubs. With Wake Forest with a 2-0 lead on the scoreboard. Lapa's still in the match. They play Tater Rinhack. A lot of freshmen on the playing field for the Deacons right now, with Colby Carr here, Cadniacci to the left, well as Holcomb up here, and Rula on the left. A little too heavy, that won't go out of bounds for a throw-in for the Spartans. Under 7 minutes to go. Wake Forest just ticking the clock down to 11-0. And there's our next broadcast. Remember, next Tuesday, 7 p.m., it'll be the Panthers of High Point coming in, taking on the number one Wake Forest Demon Deacons. If they can get us some good result at Syracuse. Kyle McCurley checks into the ballgame for the Deacons. A sophomore, part of that great freshman class last year. And Ricky Zari will come in for John Milligan. Zari had a lot of time in between the pipes earlier this season. And John Milligan got back to full strength. Started against Elon. And coming into tonight's game, only allowed 2 goals in the times he started. Tonight, he's allowed 2 to this explosive Wake Forest offense. Off of Rinhack, and Rinhack tried to play it off. It's a throw-in for the Deacons, but it'll be a throw-in for the Spartans. So if things continue this way, as it looks to be, with about 5 minutes left to go, UNCG will fall to 4-6. Go to 2-3 on the away games as they prepare for Southern Conference slate. And we'll start things off against Belmont. Of course, that East Tennessee State game will be homecoming for UNCG, because UNCG doesn't have a football team, so they use the soccer team, which is another key to recruiting. A good reason why they have such a nice facility up there in Greensboro. There's Ricky Zari, 6'1". Goal out average about 1.65. Here's a free kick. See if UNCG can get on the board. Rinhack fighting for it. And they'll call the foul. Rinhack and Manny Apo getting into it. Apo, let's take a look at the play here. Apo just with a shove. Not happy with Tater Rinhack, the extra touch there. Johnston. Has fit right in here at Wake Forest, coming from St. John. As he has five assists. On the year. The player that flirting with 2 minutes left to go, and Wake Forest with a a 2-0 lead. The Spartans continue to attack. Cagnacci off the hand with a great slide tackle as he timed it perfectly, but it popped up and hit his hand, and it'll be a free kick awarded to UNCG. In the 58th minute. Let's see if Casas Mundet can keep the clean sheet here as the Spartans line up probably about 22 yards away from the net. Referee with a red card here. See what's going on here. This is interesting to say the least. And a red card. See who that is to. I believe that is to Nicholas Matei. As we're paused here at Spry Stadium. He will go off. I'm not sure exactly what or why the red card was awarded. But there is a red card first for UNCG. Let's see what happens here. I think he said something directly at the referee, and I believe that's why he had enough. And referee Trey Krell goes out and brings the red card booking. Some more confusion going on. It's Lamate who gets the red card. The junior who has 9 appearances this year. It's a transfer from Tyler Junior College. Part of those 2-time national championships. And he is sent off with about two minutes to go. I was protesting about pulling of the jersey. Obviously something that had occurred by Wake Forest that he was not happy with, that the referee did not seem to catch. But something I haven't seen in a good while is a referee going over to the coach and then walking with that red card in his hand and then issuing the red card. Usually you see it go to the pocket and then pull it out over the head of the player that is awarded that card, but this time the referee went and spoke with Coach Justin Mullen before he brought the red card over to Lamate. Under a minute, Wake Forest trying to find goal number three on the night. And again, Wake Forest has put up at least three goals on the season each game. So this could be a win in itself for the Spartans if they can keep Wake Forest to just two. It looks like that's what they're going to do as Wake Forest moves it around the back and plays some possession. As they'll take the win 2-0 over UNCG before they head on the road to Syracuse. Clemson now goes ahead of Charleston in the 84th minute. 2-1 that score. Kudos to my crew as usual. You guys do a great job. Unbelievable. And, of course, my intern, HB, has been on point as usual. Celebrating her first ACC win of the season on Sunday. And Wake Forest moves to 11-0 on the season. And Bobby Buse goes to 66 wins at Wake Forest. So 66 wins since 2015. There's Coach Muse and the white polo. Wake Forest with a great win, especially on a Tuesday. They get the win over UNCG Spartans, preseason selected to win the SOCON. To watch this entire game on replay, as well as other games on ESPN family of networks, log on to watchespn.com or download the Watch ESPN app. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. So for my crew, I'm Ty Collins. We'll see you next time, next Tuesday, High Point, right here. See you next time.